Good morning. My name is Catherine Leisner, and I am the manager of the Engineering Co-op Career Services Office. Thank you for joining us today. We're very excited to be here with you with some wonderful special guests as we present the Co-op Students of the Year Award. We will also be taking time to recognize our co-op supervisors and all the students who were nominated. Over the duration of the next 5 to 10 minutes, you'll be joined by several guests, all here excited to share their journey with you. It's important to take time to recognize the outstanding students and individuals who have contributed to cooperative education and work integrated learning over the past year. Normally we'd be on campus celebrating together in a very large room. And so it's important that while we're not on campus, we still continue to recognize all the fantastic work experiences that are taking place. All right, I'd like to introduce you to our nominated students. Being nominated is a huge honor. For the rest of your career, you'll be able to add to your resume or your LinkedIn the fact that you contributed your work ethic, professionalism, and were nominated by individuals for your experience. So congratulations to these individuals, Alessa, Andrew, Aurora, Bilal, Damien, Laura, Luning, Matthew, Michelle, Monica, and Ryan. The faculty is extremely proud of you, and we look forward to seeing where your career goes as future leaders. We wouldn't be anywhere without our supervisors, the individuals who support our students. 2 weeks ago, we formally recognized our supervisors of the year, and they are listed here. Thank you so much for all the support you give to our students. We wouldn't be able to run strong work integrated learning programs if we didn't have strong mentors and peers available for our students. And now a message from our dean.
Hi, I'm Aisha Bhutto, Dean of Engineering at McMaster University. Congratulations to all of the McMaster Engineering students who took part in a cooperative education experience this last year. You're all tremendous examples of the value of real-world experience outside the classroom. And congratulations as well to our recognized supervisors for their support of our students' work-integrated learning journey. And finally, special congratulations to our two Faculty of Engineering winners, Aisha Bhutto, Electrical Engineering, and Kevin Pereira, Mechanical Engineering and Society. Thank you for being such great ambassadors for McMaster Engineering and for sharing your vast cooperative education experiences with your peers.
Okay, our first co-op student of the year recipient, Kevin Pereira, is in his final year of Mechanical Engineering and Society. Kevin has completed a 12-month co-op experience at Bayless Medical, finishing this spring, 2020. Kevin is also a founder and co-president of Mechanical Engineering Design Team and plans to pursue a master's degree in Biomedical Engineering. Congratulations, Kevin.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Kevin. How has your co-op at McMaster Engineering impacted your career plan?
So my co-op with Bayless was fantastic. I got to work in three very diverse departments and learn a lot about the medical device industry. I think my co-op has really taught me about what it takes to work in the medical device industry and how you can really learn about the different workings within that field. I look forward to a career in the medical device industry, and all the support that I got from McMaster really helped that to make that experience great.
And what would you say is your greatest takeaway from your co-op experience?
There were three things that really stood out for me. And I think the first thing is trusting a team is always hard, but it's something that is really important. And my supervisor, Andrew, taught me that. Really trusting a team, whether it would with McMaster MedT, which is my student club, or even at Bayless, working with those people and trusting them is kind of the biggest thing. And the second thing is you're more capable of things than you can realize. And so, you know, we all have imposter syndrome sometimes, and you really just have to step outside your comfort zone and really try things that are new. And the final thing is just have fun, that when you have fun with the job that you're taking on, you tend to do a lot better than if you're always worried about what could or could not be. So I had a great experience, and thank you from the ECCS Milich, my supervisor, guidance counselor. Thanks for everything.
Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. When I saw the nomination list, I was extremely ecstatic and very proud and very happy. I like to present Aisha Bhutto is a third year electrical engineering student who started her co-op journey with a 4-month role after year one as an IT infrastructure intern with Peel Regional Police in Mississauga. Followed by this, she secured a 16-month role with IBM as a software analyst engineer, where her primary responsibility is working with high profile clients solving complex technical issues. Her plans after graduating is for her to wish to continue her role as a customer software engineer. Congratulations, Aisha. So well earned and deserved.
Thank you, Jesse.
Congratulations, Aisha. How has co-op at McMaster Engineering impacted your career plan?
Yeah, so prior to co-op at MacEng, I had very little knowledge of the different types of roles that were available. And co-op definitely helped me find my strengths. I found what I was good at, and I created opportunities for myself to, I guess, showcase my skills as an engineer. I found certain tasks and roles and projects, and they really showed what I was capable of. So my career plans have changed just based on the strengths I found along my journey. So I started off with very little knowledge, but I can confidently say I ended off knowing exactly what I want to do and where I want to be.
That's great. And what is your greatest takeaway from your co-op experience?
Yeah, there were a lot of takeaways from the entire journey, but the greatest by far is knowing that I have made an impact, whether that was internally with my team or externally with the clients that I was working with. As an intern, you're a small fish in an ocean of talent, and I met different people at different career levels along the way, entry level, senior managers, or directors. And from each of these people, I learned how to make an impact. I took their successes and really, really learned from it to see how I can make a difference as well. And that by far definitely has been the greatest takeaway, just knowing I've made a difference amongst many people in a very large company. I just want to say thank you, McMaster Engineering, for all the support. I know, Jesse, you've been there since the first year as well. And thank you, my family and my boss as well, for supporting me along the way.
Thank you, Aisha. That was great. And Kevin as well. It's so nice to hear about your journey and the impact that your co-op work experience has had. And it's nice to see some family and friends here today as well, because we know that a strong, your support systems are all so important. So thank you. Every year we have a large number of students that go out on co-op work experiences. To be, there's 13 students today that we're celebrating, and you're both two of those 13. But on average, we have about 2,200 students going out on co-op each year. So we are extremely proud, of both of you that, from those large numbers of 2,200 students that you are, a representative now for all those future students based on your fantastic journeys. To all our students who are watching this today, we just want to say, congratulations to everyone on your work experience, especially during the last year. It's been a strange year. You've all pivoted. You've listened to lots of emails from us and heard from us as we all pivoted as a country and a co-op program together. So we've all been here, alongside you. The summer 2021 term is starting to look up. The economy is slowly picking up, and that's great to hear for engineering programs, which were some of the hardest hit in the cooperative education landscape. So keep applying, keep contacting our office. There's lots of great things on the horizon, and we look forward to being here to support you and then seeing who our co-op students of the year will be for 2021 next year in March. Take care. Have a great day.